Sixx Sense with Nikki Sixx.
It's Jen and Nikki. It's Sixx Sense. We are in Cleveland at the Alternative Press Music Awards. And we're here with Halestorm.
Yes. Hello.
In person.
Hi.
So great to finally see you.
I know.
We met years ago, and it's been years.
I've had a child. You know what I mean?
How old is your kid?
He's 8.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, that's awesome. Nice.
Congrats.
Yeah, thanks. He's a handful. Well, but you know. Did I tell you the story about when I first saw you perform?
I'm not sure.
Okay, so you were at Ram's Head in Baltimore, and you, right, and you did the Shinedown Trap Tour.
Yeah. Wow, oh, my goodness. Yeah, so.
You were 6?
No, 2006.
I was like, I was 9. Yeah, so it was right before I got pregnant, and I just decided to drink a lot. We had shots, and then I had shots, and then I went on the bus with Brent and... what's his name from Trap? Chris.
Mm-hmm.
And then I woke up in the hospital.
Oh my gosh.
And I was like,
pregnant?
Wait, I remember Halestorm.
Woke up in the hospital pregnant.
They took a pregnancy test. Did you know that?
In the hospital?
Yeah, like if you ever go really? And you're like super drunk or whatever, they test you. Yeah.
Oh, whoa. That's so weird.
I was
didn't
not
know that.
Pregnant, which I was like, first of all, you were very invasive. Don't take a pregnancy test on me. I didn't ask for that. Second of all, I don't know if they like pumped my stomach. But yeah, that was the first time I saw you guys perform, and I was like, this is how we go.
Well, a great first impression.
Apparently that was a hell of a first impression.
Jesus.
That's amazing.
But is it?
I don't know.
Well, we're glad that you're okay.
Yeah.
And you're here.
What a night.
What a night. Okay.
Yeah. Never went back there. You guys have, I guess
dirty
had.
Dirty Baltimore.
No, dirty. It's so dirty. Number one album. You had a number one album.
Did we? When? Do we?
Rock charts.
Oh, rock. Oh, yeah.
Alternative charts.
Yes, I know.
Remember that time you had a number one album?
Sorry, we've been following our latest and like people are telling us all the stuff that's going on. We're like, really? What? So, how much you miss when you're inside of it. Usually when we hear about those things and all the firsts and you know, just the stats on it. You know, the first response is like, seriously, there has to be somebody else. It's crazy, you know, because we just keep it moving and have always just kind of done what we love. And so it's really crazy that we can actually say that this is a career and that we've had, you know, a bunch of number ones. Now it's like, who knew, right? So
when you were writing this album, I know we talked about doing the whole thing in the church in Nashville in a circle and that whole thing. But did, like, when you send it out into the world, are you like, this is it ever? Is there a time where you feel it just in your bones?
With this one in particular, because we did it so differently, we were proud of it. Cause I feel like this is the most Halestorm record that we've ever done. Like we had a mission and we went in there and we accomplished it and we had such a fun time doing it. We love every song, including all the B-sides, you know? And so, yeah, there is a moment where you're like, this is awesome. I don't know what it's going to do, but this is awesome. And then you send it out in the world, and you're like,
Yeah.
You go full Tina from Bob's Burgers.
I can't do it. I try every time. Anyway.
Anyway, yeah, so we just went off on a tangent here.
Tune it out.
Do you guys?
Never go full Tina.
I think, yeah, like Lzzy said, we did this album completely different from the last two. When we first went into the studio, I think we were all a bit nervous because our approach to this was to make a lot to record it live, and I think we were all confident that you know, fully capable of doing it. And but I think we were all a little bit nervous before, you know, we started press and record. Like, can we do this? This is it. I mean, we got to do it. And we recorded Mayhem first. Once we went through it, you know, first pass on it, it was like, oh,
yeah,
this is good. This is good. Do what
we
do.
Something that we haven't really talked about a whole lot is that with all of the songs, instead of what we were used to, which is like we have all the songs like done and finish and arrange and then we record it and like we know what we're doing. When we walked into the studio day one, we have the demo and we're thinking we're just gonna like play it like we did on the demo or like we would live, you know? And then we ended up screwing up every song in some awesome way. Like,
oh, that's just, right. Yeah, you, just we talked
literally,
about that.
Yeah, just literally like, hey, you know what? Let's take this whole part out and just write another part. Like, just let's spend 5 minutes and just write something. Cool. So it's scary to trust yourself, you know? And so it's, I don't know, it's cool that we did, but, you know.
So as far as this award show goes, I sat out there and watched you guys rehearse for in rehearsal, and I like everywhere chills from my fingernails to my toenails.
That's nice of you.
Who the hell picked that song? Oh, it's a genius idea. Who did who?
We covered today Hunger Strike, right? We covered Hunger Strike a couple of years ago.
Oh my god!
On a cover EP, and we never really did. Nothing really ever came of it. It was like there were a couple other songs that everyone kind of gravitated toward. So
we never could play it live because it's a two singer song. You know?
Yeah,
so,
well, on the recording, I'm singing it with my a duet with myself. You know?
Nobody wants to sing with me.
So it was just such a cool idea, and I love. I mean, seriously, this is like two of rock's biggest iconic voices together in a freaking band doing this song way back in the day, and it's like I think that it needs to be done again. You know, so. Yeah.
Remember we used to cover Say Hello to Heaven? Remember
Yeah, that was a good one, too.
High song, too.
Yeah. Forward, back.
We're going to have to dig into that record again. And
that's a good record.
Yeah, I've been listening to it since we've been prepping for this. Yeah. And it's damn good. Record.
Maybe, hey, we're doing this tour coming up with All Hail Storm All the Time. We could just throw that in there. We can do what we want.
T-O-D.
You know, not only did you sing with Corey Taylor, but you guys have an orchestra behind you.
Oh, yeah.
Another end of it. Oh my God, the end of it. When they're like,
bucket list.
I know. we couldn't hear a whole lot of it on stage.
Beautiful.
But, and by the way, speaking of iconic voices, Corey Taylor just.
Hell yeah.
He's awesome because he walks up there. He's like, he doesn't have in ears in. He's not. You can't even.
He was late.
You can't even hear him in the monitor mix. And I'm like, do you want that up? He's like, no, I'm fine. It's cool. I'm like, you're the boss.
Yeah.
It's cool.
Dude's a beast.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
Like every generation has like a boss, you know, like, I mean, there's Bruce Springsteen, of course, he's the boss, but Corey's the boss.
He's the new boss. The vice boss.
But yeah, the kids that are in the orchestra are just amazing, and they're adorable. Sorry, not to.
We're going to start calling Corey the CEO.
But they're awesome.
You know, Springsteen was the boss. Corey Taylor is the CEO.
You still on that?
We're just going to call him that.
Okay. Yeah, no, just take your time.
Okay. I just came up with it. I'm sorry about the delay, but I just came up with it now. I was like, oh my God, it's brilliant. I need to tell the world.
He's going
to
bring up
Corey Taylor,
in 20 minutes.
The CEO. Anyway, go on. What are you saying?
What's this wee crap?
Anyway, but that's another
they
first.
Were adorable.
The chairman. Yeah,
that's another first for us. We've never actually. Who gave him a microphone? We've never actually performed live with an orchestra before, so this is first for us. And
you should do that on the next album,
right? That'd be super cool.
No, really.
Yeah.
Okay.
We want to take him on tour with us.
I'm down.
So you've set the bar up here. Now where do you go? I mean, the next album is gonna like. It's going to be insane. You know, and I know that it's hard. And I don't like being somebody that talks to bands and talking about, well, you just put one out. Now what about the next one? But at the same time, you really did set the bar high. And so where does your brain go from there? Do you just focus on the now?
I think that's all we've kind of ever done. Just kind of, you know, like Josh says this all the time. He's probably about to say it now, but I'll steal it. But you know, we chase after whatever gets us excited. That's what we did. This record, we needed to shake things up, just not even just as a professional thing, but personally, you know, and just for our own sanity within our camp and our music, we needed to shake things up. So I don't know. I think that we'll just
can't look back.
Yeah, we just keep going.
Don't try to recreate
whatever
the
at
old,
the moment.
Don't try to top the old. You just gotta.
You're
going to
do an
stretch.
EDM record next, right?
Yeah.
I think we should do it down in the Caribbean. There's an awesome studio down there called Compass Point. We can get some of those island vibes and really, you know.
Make some reggae happen.
I'm down for doing a record on an island.
We're going to make a reggae. We're going to make a reggae.
This isn't special. This is every day.
I can't even.
They aren't like acting up for you.
Welcome
they do
to the
this
world
every
of
day.
Halestorm.
Hello.
Now you're in it.
On the bus, are you just awake all the time?
Oh, yes.
Like, this one is up all freaking night.
All the time.
Usually I'm keeping
the
driver
awake. Do you poke people
awake?
In their bunks? I feel like you'd be that guy that would like go under and be like,
I keep a
what
marching,
are you doing?
I've got a marching band snare drum and I just walk up and down the bunk hole. Wake
good
up,
morning!
Come on!
I have gotten a foot in the face before, but one of you guys, somebody sticks their foot out.
Are you sure that was a foot?
I'm not sure. It was dark.
Poor thing. Oh, boy.
Let's just move on.
So anyway, Corey Taylor.
You were on Corey's album that's up and coming. Is that right or wrong?
Yeah. He just, it's funny because I wasn't even really, I didn't know that I was allowed to talk about it. And then they started posting stuff. I'm like, oh, okay.
Oh, it's online.
It's cool. Yeah. It's all over blah around.
And you had
stuff.
A number one record.
So, yeah. And that was online, too.
Tell us more about us.
I know, right? Please tell us more about us. Thank you. We need to start calling her for all of our news. It's awesome. It's actually a song I've always wanted to sing. They did a cover of Gimme Shelter, and it's a song I've always wanted to do. And I think somewhere along the line, we kind of have talked about it over the years. Mm-hmm. And then they did it, and I got random calls like, hey, do you want to sing this with us? I'm like,
I do.
Sure.
I do.
We have a little bit of time off at the moment, and went down to the studio. Josh Ryan just ended up flying, you know, and sitting in with me and just making sure everything went cool. And yeah, it was fun.
Wow.
It was a lot of fun. It's kind of it's really cool. You guys are in for a hell of a record. Everything sounds just amazing.
There's a whole bunch of people on it, right?
I'm not sure, actually, if there's a whole bunch of people, but.
Sounds a bit sour.
You're on. I'm included in the bunch of people if there are.
All right, guys. I'm excited for tomorrow night to watch you perform. This is going to be too. Insane.
I can't wait.
So excited.
Me too. We're going to have so much fun. We're going to puke.
Cool.
All over the
probably
orchestra.
Oh, that's great.
Projectile.
All right, both. Great.
Yeah, adorable.
Best of luck. Best of everything.
You know, that was a nice bookend, Lzzy, to the first story and at the end.
Yeah, puking. Yeah, puking. Well, I don't know if I puked or not.
Puking
I don't remember.
Was a common topic
I just remember
with Halestorm.
You, and then I was like, oh, I'm in the hospital.
Okay, so we're going to rock so hard, you're all going to need pregnancy tests.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. Good luck. The bill comes later.
If you're ovulating, keep your distance. We're okay. So potent.
Okay, bye.
Nikki Sixx and Jen on the Sixx Sense.
Bye.
Bye.
Goodbye. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.